Welcome to this module 10 on manufacturing systems technology. A quick recap of the last module, we were talking about or discussing about non-parametric representation of equations of a straight line followed by an ellipse. And then we discussed about the implicit case in which an ellipse can be represented, formulated a parametric equation in terms of an angle alpha, which varies between 0 and 360 degrees. And then basically also talked about how a complex topology can be split up into different synthetic curves with a precedence relationship between the different elements of the curve, and discussed concepts of continuity in this particular module. Further, I mentioned that probably today I am going to talk over a little bit details about how these fits of the various sections of the curves can be made, and also how the variation of the curves along a certain domain, a local domain, can be made by changing the different parameters related to the fit that is in question. So let's look at the Hermite cubic spline fit, or how to plot a Hermite cubic spline curve. So what are the basic assumptions in such a system? The first thing that we probably need to find out is the basic function, which in this case turns out to be a cubic polynomial. Obviously, what we are proposing is a sort of a parametric equation, which is more flexible, as you have seen before, that you can really vary it over a local domain given a certain global range within which the curve is there. And what all is needed is that, first of all, we need to sort of develop the equation which will involve some parameter. Let's say we call this parameter a t, which will have a cubic form, of course. And the next step is to fit the equation that has been developed to certain conditions which can be mapped directly from the topology. That you are wanting to fit. So let's say we have an equation, a cubic polynomial function, Vt equals a0 plus a1t plus a2t square plus a cube t, a3t cube, where t varying between 0 and 1 is the parameter. The Hermite cubic spline tries to define the curve being estimated more meaningfully in terms of certain end conditions, and these end conditions can match with the conditions of the topology that you would like to map. Okay, and in this particular case, it so happens that the basic premise is that the curve that is being formulated between two such points, point let's say A and point B on the topology, corresponding to the parameter t equal to 0 and a function v which has been indicated here, and v1. Okay, so in a way, on the topology, if you have a xyz coordinate system, you can plot what really is the x and y dimensions or coordinates on that topology. And this can be mapped by any measuring system like CMM, etc. And then also the slopes at both the ends which are important for formulating this particular fit. We call it V-0 and V-1. So the end conditions, which are more like measurable conditions, are the points along both the ends which you need to fit, and the slopes at those points, which are sort of the global domain for the whole curve starting between A and B, as can be seen in this particular figure. So how do we develop this connectivity, or how do we develop this set of, you know, different points which gives this cubic relationship between the point A and the point B on the topology, is the main question. So obviously the end conditions that we probably need to use are V0, V1, V-0 and V-1. Why are we choosing these end conditions also is quite important, and it has to be addressed. So let's look at that, how we can really do a curve fitting of this particular equation. So the best idea is to be able to keep on varying t between 0 and 1, as has been illustrated here, and try to find out what are these different parameters a1, a2 and a3, given the end conditions which are already known to you. So v0, which is the end, which is representing the end A, is corresponding to some coordinate point xa, ya, and let's say this is measurable data from coming out of some CMM or something. Similarly, xb, yb, some coordinate point, and you know, the slopes are also the measurable data at both the ends of the topology. We will come back to address this issue, that how difficult it is to really measure the slope, and one of the reasons why Hermite cubic spline fit may not be preferred in comparison to some other fits like Bezier, etc., where only the end points are needed and their variation is needed to sort of map the topology. So here, let's say we first of all try to calculate the V-t, which is essentially A1 plus twice A2t plus 3A3t square. And then we try to put the end conditions corresponding to t equal to 0 and t equal to 1 and find out what are the different end conditions. We already know the set xa, ya, which is corresponding to the end condition v0. Similarly, the set xb, yb, which is corresponding to the end condition v1. Okay, and this data is, as I told you earlier, measured data, which can be used for fitting to that topology which you are measuring this particular piece of the curve, synthetic curve. So here V-0 is actually equal to A1, and V0 from this equation, you know, let's say equation 1 and equation 2, V0 is equal to A0. And similarly, if we go on the other side and do V1, V1 comes out to be equal to A0 plus A1 plus A2 plus A3. And similarly, V-1 comes out to be equal to A1 plus twice A2 plus thrice A3. So at the two end conditions corresponding to t equal to 0 and corresponding to t equal to 1, we have now sort of four equations where, mind you, these v0, v-0, v1 and v-1, they are all known variables. So the v0, v-0, v1 and v-1, they are all known variables. And we want to represent the unknowns, which are the a0 to a3, in terms of the known variables. So what we do is we try to solve these equations which have been formulated. Okay, these are linear equations, and come up with a solution which is written in a manner that a0 is actually equal to v0, a1 equals v-0, a2 equals thrice v1 minus v0 minus twice v-0 minus v-1, and a3 equals twice v0 minus v1 plus v-0 plus v-1. So once these parameters a0 to a3 are known, we can actually substitute these back into our cubic polynomial function so that you could fit the particular polynomial to the topology which is in concern. So therefore Vt, the final polynomial, can be written down as V0 if I do some algebraic manipulation in a way that, you know, we assemble all the V0s, the coefficients with the V0s, V1, V dash 0, V dash 1 as together. So we have V0 times of 1 minus 3t square plus twice t cube plus V1 times of thrice t square minus twice t cube plus V dash 0 times of t minus twice t square plus t cube plus V dash 1 times of minus t square plus t cube as the main equation, which is the fitted equation in this particular case. You can see that the end conditions V0, V1, V dash 0 and V dash 1 are known. Again, I am just sort of ascertaining this point, and based on that you can develop an equation in cubic order which can actually fit the real life surface or the real topology which is in particular question. Okay. So obviously we are doing a 2D mapping right now, but this can be extendable to the 3 dimension where you also have the Z component. It will become a little more complex and we will take this up separately as a module. But if you are doing a 2 dimensional curve fit kind of a situation between 2 points, it is very easy to go in this manner and formulate a fit. So if I were to construct this equation for the R in terms of, you know, multiplying matrices, we can say that R becomes equal to 1 plus 1 t square t cube times of some kind of a basis matrix times of the values V0, V1, V dash 0 and V dash 1. Okay. And this basis matrix, if you lay this equation out in a proper manner, equation 1 out in a proper manner, and try to separate out the multipliers, comes out to be 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, minus 3, 3, minus 2, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 1, 1. Okay. So that's how you can actually do a fit with this basis matrix, a matrix which has all the essential slopes and the end conditions, the end slopes and the end coordinates, and the vector comprising of the various orders of the parameter t. And I would just like to illustrate in the next module how sort of in the next example problem that how you can actually do a curve fit, how such a fit can be made. For example, in this problem, we want to determine and plot the equation of Hermite form of cubic spline fit, and we have been given position vectors and slopes at data points with vector magnitudes equal to 1. The data points are point A or point 1 corresponding to A on the curve that I had illustrated earlier. The x and y values are 1 and 2, and similarly at B the x and y values and 3 and 1. Obviously the slopes are also given to be 60 degrees and 30 degrees at both the end conditions. So in this manner we have to fit the equation that we had formulated earlier to these end conditions, and then we will try to physically plot them and see that what is really the variability of the surface aspect. So if you vary the different end conditions, as you will see in this particular case, mostly it is the magnitude of the slope that will vary. The curves, there would be a family of curves which are generated, and the idea is then that whatever topological mapping is needed can be done by looking at the topology and looking at this variation in the local domain of the curve, and several such synthetic curves are plotted in unison to one another so that the whole surface can get mapped up. So we are going to do this particular plotting and mapping in the next module. Thank you.